manuscript just sitting on my hard drive, I ran into, I had a chance meeting with another self-published author, Kathleen McGowan, and she said, you have to self-publish this. This sounds like a great book. Long story short is that Kathleen's book became was picked up by Simon & Schuster, became a New York Times bestseller. She's had three books on the New York Times bestselling list. She's a bestselling author on seven continents, but she never would have had the chance had she not self-published first. So my goal was to put out a product that didn't look self-published because there was this huge stigma. This was back in 2006. I was fortunate that my partner happens to be a wonderful graphic designer, so he did a beautiful cover for the book. We invented a name of a publishing company to put on the frontispiece. I went through Book Search because Kathleen had gone through Book Search and she said, it won't say Book Search any place in your book. Nobody will know the difference. So we put this product together and Book Search completely handled all of the sales on Amazon, the distribution to Ex Libris and Baker & Taylor, and all of the other areas that a traditional publisher would. And what I found after about a year was, after 9 months, my book hit number two on Amazon in gay fiction. I was selling a lot of books, and I was getting these really nice big royalty checks. And I was thinking, what am I missing here? All this time I was chasing my tail thinking I needed an agent and I needed a publisher, and what I found was that the skies opened and said, you don't need it still, and I still run into the stigma of being a self-published author. I was really fortunate exactly a year ago when I was approached by Amazon Encore, and that's the new imprint for Amazon, and they said, you know, would you like to be one of our authors? And so they actually, after Strings Attached was in production for 3.5 years, and they edited the book, and they put some new covers on it, and they've handled the distribution and the promotion, and actually it's now in its fifth week of being number one on Amazon in the gay and lesbian titles. But I feel very, very strongly that had I not done self-publishing first, had I not forged ahead, that it may have never happened. So my interest here isn't trying to convince people, you know, do it. If you're getting this wall of resistance and this wall of silence from the traditional publishing industry, do it.
We've had this whole technological sea change going on that's really changed everything. And I have to echo Bronwyn in saying, not only are the rules being rewritten, nobody has a clue what they are. Mainstream publishers do not know what they are. And so, in a certain way, it's a time of tremendous energy and possibility. But what I see get in people's way, and you know, partly I come to this conversation not only as a writer, but as a teacher of writers, and I see my students with captive of the old myth that I'm going to get a New York agent. They're going to get me a New York publisher. I'm going to get a review in the New York Times. I'm going to get on Oprah. And that's their dream. And then I'm going to quit my job and just live off my royalties. Okay, well, I don't know anybody who's doing that at this point, let alone a new writer who's starting out. Yes, there are a few people for whom parts of that dream still work, but it is by no means the general pathway that people can follow any longer. And so kind of redefining what success means, what success looks like, and particularly going back to remembering that what the job is to connect with readers. I write something, I want to communicate, I want to find you and you and you and you to take that in and receive that in some way. And all the rest is kind of a different kind of conversation. So I've been working with a group of people who are all committed to not being a victim of the situation and finding our way through and finding creative solutions. And there isn't one path, there are multiple paths. But a lot of it really relies on our initiative. You might get somebody to publish you, that doesn't mean they're going to market your book.